Hello, I'm Bill Luxton, and I've got a poem written by tonight's special guest. I see a woman wearing a hat, the funniest I've ever seen. It was too late for April Fool, and too soon for Halloween. Our guest tonight, the poet laureate of show business, Nipsey Russel. And now, welcome to the amazing world of Kreskin.
Oh, God, with a welcome like that, there's no point in going on, folks. Thank you so much. I guess with an enthusiasm expressed from an audience like this, the most appropriate thing I could do, really, is to try to tune in on your thoughts, pick up ideas that are in your mind. Most performers, so-called psychics in this field, have objects passed forward, you know, or envelopes, and each thought reader or psychic holds the envelope to their head and gets a headache, I think, because I can't figure out what you can get from a sealed envelope. So since I haven't collected anything, just do me a favor and concentrate, and I'll try to tune in. Stand if I say something that rings a bell. I get a name or a word or a thought. I'll jot down what I start to get. I write R. I write if the pencil would. R-A-M. It seems like it's part of a thought. Would this person kindly stand if it rings a bell in their mind, please? Rams, R-A-M-S, does that ring a bell? The lady over here is standing. Don't tell me, you look like you're about to contribute, ma'am, to what I'm saying. Is it a name of someone or something?
A place.
A place? Mm-hmm. In this town?
No.
Close your eyes and visualize the rest of the name of the place. There's a G in it?
Yes.
A?
Yes.
T?
Yes.
Ramsgate?
Yes.
Where is that?
In England.
In England. Are you from there or have you visited there?
From there.
Thank you for standing. I appreciate it. Wow. Just real quick, raise your hand, because at this time of the year, no one would think of it for the season. It's not that time of the year. Who's thinking of Halloween? Just raise your hand. Where are you? You're stunned, ma'am. You are? Why were you thinking of Halloween? Why Halloween of all times of the year?
Well, it's my child's birthday.
Was born on Halloween. Mm-hmm. Thanks so much. I really appreciate it. I also... It seems to me in the audience, someone is thinking of school, and then they're also thinking of love. Would this person kindly stand who really has this in mind? Very quickly, where are you? Who in the house here? Nobody? Come down to the girl over here. Let's get in through to her.
No.
Were you thinking of school and love, ma'am?
Well, I was thinking...
Why love, may I say?
Well, it was a very good friend of mine that I...
You have someone in mind whose name who is a miss rather than a missus or a mister? Yes or no?
No.
No? All right. I'm going to stop here. I'm having difficulty. I knew sooner or later this would kind of happen. The thoughts are too general. I'm going to end it here because it's just too difficult to go on, but thanks so much for your cooperation. We'll be back very shortly.
Great. I had two people join me from the audience. As a matter of fact, I don't know you folks, do I? What is your name?
Jean.
Jean, it's nice to meet you. And your name, sir?
Jim.
Jim, I'd like you actually here as witnesses. It's a funny thing, during the commercial, during the break, I didn't even ask people in the audience questions, but I've got to ask something. Anyone in the audience, just raise your hand. When we went to commercial, I got this as a flash impression. I didn't pursue it. Is someone here thinking of Disneyland? Just raise your hand. You again, ma'am? I truly was getting, and you were not thinking of Disneyland in Hollywood. You were thinking of Disneyland, Florida, weren't you? Have you been there?
Not yet.
You're thinking of going there. And I never asked you this. Am I correct? Thank you so much. So one more thing before anyone applauds. No, it was in my mind, and I will rarely do this, but once on the Mike Douglas show, we almost stopped and revered back. Who was thinking of the initials LD? They were burning in my mind. Lady right there. First name was Liz. Liz, who is that? Stan, miss. Who is Liz to you?
Liz is a close friend at work.
Would you and your... We've never met, have we? No. I did not ask you this during the commercial break. In your mind, what's your first name?
Marika.
Marika, think of her last name, but say nothing. How many letters to it? Seven?
Seven.
You were going to say six, weren't you?
Yes, I
corrected you. I'll help you anytime. That name I see, and we've not prearranged anything, am I correct? Would it be Drury?
That's right.
Thank you, ma'am, so much. Well, I had to do that. I got to tell you, I had to do it because it was burning in my mind, and I was confused with so many people with the same thoughts. This is a card effect I didn't have a chance to mention, but it's a way of bringing together a family in the sense of family of cards. It is a straight deck of playing cards. The jokers have been removed. It really doesn't matter whether we realize it or not. Would you take that pencil up in your hand, please, and hold it more at the point, I think, than the end. That way we won't be marking the cards. Stick the eraser part into the deck as I riffle through. It's an interesting way, I think, of finding a card. Would you do me a favor? In fact, I will just push it out. Move away a little bit to your side. We'll drop the card there. We'll place the pencil on top of it, in order, in a sense, to mark that card. Now, I haven't seen the card. You haven't as well. There's no way of anyone knowing through natural means unless the deck were marked, and believe me, it is a straight deck. But what I propose to do is to locate the mates of that card by cutting this deck. These are 52 different playing cards. I've given it what we call a multiple cut, and right or wrong, I think I missed. You'll have to forgive me. I can just tell by the sense of touch. This is why I have a wild time in Vegas. Or Reno, if you will. It is a king. It is the king of clubs. We'll set it as it is. Now, if I may cut the deck one more time and give it this time a multiple cut, kind of standard cut if you're fancy with cards, my friends, I hope. Another king. The king of hearts. And I'll tell you one thing, these cards are all different. This time we'll give it the kind of shuffle, truly, this is, I don't mean this jokingly, that's popular in India. It is called a Hindu shuffle. It's a series of cuts. Let's try for the third king to the bottom. There you are. Third king. A little closer. Now, there was one final king. Do you remember which one would be missing, sir, that we haven't gotten to yet?
The spades.
The spade? Would it be remarkable, without seeing this card under the pencil, if it were the fourth king, which is... Well, I must tell you folks something. Obviously, I haven't hit it. I've gotten the three kings, but I haven't gotten the fourth. It was an ace I should have been aiming for each time. But listen, there should be ways of correcting an error. I should have looked for the four aces. How about if I take that ace in my hand and merely push it through like that, so it joins the three kings? Wouldn't it be remarkable if it changed to a king? Literally joining the other three, the family of three. Let me turn it over. I'll tell you what, folks. Look, it's an ace of spades, yes. But look, the ace of clubs, the ace of diamonds, and the ace of hearts. There you are. Thank you. We'll be back shortly with Nipsey Russel. See you shortly. My special guest is a man I've always admired. I kind of think of him as the poet laureate of humor today. His name is Nipsey Russel. Would you welcome him?
It was in a gypsy tea room, a fortune-telling place. A lovely gypsy girl read my mind, then she slapped my face.
I was going to ask you, you had a poem for us. Any comments on the program thus far? Have you been singing up in the control room?
Yes, I have, and it's been beautiful. I noticed that you have a body of people from the same place, from the same school.
Same school, yes.
And I don't know what the school is, but I say to them, seek for knowledge. Go to a college, stay there until you are through. If they could make penicillin out of moldy cheese, they can make something out of you. I think that's why your thoughts were getting crossed. You were probably reading. See, they're all thinking essentially the same thing, and so you get a...
It's really what happened. Nipsey, we're dealing with the mind, and you are in a creative way. How do you come about to create humor built around poetry? Poetry in itself is a rare art today.
Well, I think that the last time I saw you, we were on the Johnny Carson show together. And Ed McMahon had a show in the morning. It was called Missing Links. And I had two little poems that I had remembered from the time I was a child. And so, as comics are inclined to do, I was kind of smart alecky one day. And when he introduced me, I said one of the poems. And I got a hand for it. And the next day, he called on me again. And I had just one more. I did that one. I didn't know that this was going to be a continuum. So the third morning when the show opened, he went right, he said, now Nipsey's poem, I realized that I had set a format and that I was stuck. So I repeated the first one that I had done the day before, and then I started to see if I could write them. I didn't really know that I could do this, but now I've done it. I have about 200 of them that I've published.
It's part of you. Published?
That I'm publishing.
Tremendous.
Yes.
Would it be throwing you a curve if I go in the audience, take a couple of topics?
Not at
all. See what you do with it?
See,
great.
I see you got all
I'm,
kinds of...
I'm never in the audience with a mic.
Good. Go there.
Got one here. Do we have any folks along the way here that could just raise their hand and give Nipsey a topic of any kind? Just raise your hand, folks.
Well,
I'll
at least respond to the topic if it's not something...
All right. Anybody have a topic you could just give him that you'd like him to do a poem on? Yes, ma'am. Whoops.
Caterpillars.
Caterpillars?
No.
Nipsey?
That's a little too creepy.
Oh. Who has a topic here? Anyone along? What is it?
Ding-a-ling.
That's a hard one. Ding-a-ling.
Mother Nature and Father Time can't get together, it seems, because by the time we learn the games, we're too old to make the teams.
How about it? Someone give me another. You know, sometimes the simplest topics are the most difficult. Fellow, raise his hand all the way over there. What is it, sir? What? Oh, yeah, I'd like to hear about that, especially now.
Internal Revenue is calling. They say, let's face the facts. If you didn't have the income, you wouldn't owe the tax.
Oh.
You cannot take... There's more. You cannot take it with you. Well, this much we all know, but they won't let us keep enough to last until we go.
For a mentalist, I'm not sure how we're doing on time. One very quick one. Yes, sir. Snow bunnies?
Snow bunnies?
That's
I can think about the snow. I've seen it.
Yeah.
Here. The spring has sprung, the fall has fell, the winter has come, and it's colder than usual.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back very shortly with Nipsey Russel. And I'd like to show you how, perhaps in some way, thoughts have wings. See you shortly. Thank you. I want to mention something. That last interlude with Nipsey Russel, I think our viewers should realize that that was not prearranged in any way, shape, or form. There were no words given out to trigger off topics because we just don't work that way on the program. So talk about creativeness. He has it at a peak.
Oh, thank you.
I want to mention, I asked someone to come up from the audience as a witness, and we've never met, have we?
No.
What is your name?
Janice Atina.
Janice?
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful name. This is Nipsey Russel. Janice
Atina. Glad to know you, Janice.
Nice to see you. Now, Nipsey, it's a very unusual point to bring out, but before the program, I cornered Nipsey, in fact, rather quickly, because he came in just before the show, and I had things to do. And I gave him an envelope and asked him if he had a bill on his person, and you, I guess, took out a dollar bill. And I said, well, what I explained is that I wanted you to buy yourself to seal the bill in the envelope and to write something across the flap of the envelope.
Which I did.
Were you alone, Nipsey, when you did this?
Absolutely.
And the identification when you take the envelope out is strictly your own. No one would have thought of this name or known that you would have chosen.
Only one other person in the United States would even know the name.
And is that person related to you or that person themselves?
That person is a dear friend of mine.
You have the envelope on you, Nipsey?
I have.
Where did you put it after you signed it or sealed a bill in it? Did you just keep it on your person?
I've had it in the inside pocket of this jacket.
Would you take it out now? It doesn't matter if I see the name. I'd just like you to take out the envelope right at this moment and show the name on it.
Do I show it?
Yes, you can. He's really careful about it. Yeah, I can see it. It doesn't matter.
Oh, I see.
What is the name is what? Hazel?
Yeah.
And you have the bill inside the envelope? I hoped that when you had folded it, you folded it with the serial numbers. Yes, the serial numbers inside.
Right.
Now, Nipsey, I'm going to turn my back to you. Do me a favor,
if
you will. Break the seal on the envelope and take out the bill and then unfold it. Do this, if you will now, please. Take the bill out of the envelope. You can tear it open in any way you wish, but kind of leave the window intact, that part of it. Now face me so that when you open the bill, Nipsey, I cannot see the serial numbers on it.
Wow.
Take it out, if you will. Face me. Unfold the bill.
Right.
As a matter of fact, when you unfold the bill, Nipsey, I'll take the envelope and set it on the table for you. Place your thumbs over the serial numbers. Now, I can turn to you without seeing the bill, can I? The serial numbers? Fine.
Nobody can see them.
We're keeping it off camera. I just hope we are. I don't want anyone off camera to even see it. Now, Nipsey, move one thumb so that you can peek at the serial numbers of the bill.
I am.
But conceal it as best you can. In fact, I'll turn my head since someone off camera might see this. Would I be correct in saying that before we get to any numbers, the letter that comes to my mind, Nipsey, is... I'm going to be very honest with you, Nipsey. I cannot get the... There is a letter, first of all, isn't there?
But there's
I just can't...
Letter,
don't,
right.
don't tell... I just can't get it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It is me. And I must be very honest with you. I'm not getting the digits as I thought. Nipsey, regarding the numbers, I think I have the first two. Would the third digit be a repeat of a number already?
Yes, it would, indeed.
All right, then that's why I can't get it. All right, I'm going to place that down. Now, in your mind, give me the next digit, but just think it. There's a number. I'm just going to say something. There's a number repeating itself through this whole thing. It comes up again, doesn't it?
There is.
Yeah. It's most confusing. I may have confused the last two digits. I don't know. I'm going to take a shot at the letter. The last two digits are even numbers, aren't they, Nipsey?
They are.
Now, Nipsey, do me a favor, because I have written this down in ink already, and I will turn to my camera. Would you read the serial number out loud, please, slowly?
If you come close, it's a wonder, because there are a number of them repeat. The serial number is 3-1.
What's the letter before that?
B as in boy.
B is first. I have that. What comes next?
The number 3.
All right, I did not get that. I got that as a 2.
But
what comes after that?
You're right. The next number is 1, and it repeats. 1-1.
1-1 confused me considerably. And
right.
What comes next?
4.
All right, I missed on that. I just, there's nothing I can do about it. I'm writing upside down. Now, I'd like to see how I did on the last three digits. Would you give them to me?
1-6-4.
1-6-4. Do me a favor. In fact, I'd like you to pass the bill over to the lady, this lovely lady. What's your first name again, ma'am?
Janice,
read the numbers again out loud, if you will, so that we can correct them. First comes the B, which I got. Then what comes next?
3. 1-1-4-1-6-4.
4. All right, do me a favor, Janet. I did not want to touch the bill, which is why I had Nipsey give his bill to you. Would you place it inside this envelope, please? Pick the envelope as it is up. In fact, leave it open if you want. Nipsey... This has to be one of the most dramatic tests of my career. While she is doing that, I have here a picture frame, which I will turn towards our camera. There's only one thing different about the frame, and that is I've removed any picture from it.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it to Nipsey, and I'm going to ask him to hold it against his person like this. Sure, I could place like cloth over the flame, but over the frame, but I don't think it would impress anyone. So, Nipsey, if you'll do me a favor, I'm going to set this against you about like that. Hold the sides of the frame. One here. Would you hold this over here, please? Like that. Keep it against you thusly.
Have done.
Now, ma'am, you have placed his bill in the envelope, and we have prearranged nothing. Am I correct, ma'am? Let's hold this. In fact, you hold it over the tray as it sits in front of us. Just hold the whole envelope. Turn the face of the envelope, the window, towards the camera, which is out here. You better hold it at the very end. Because we're at the very end, the very tip right over here, in the other hand.
This can't be done.
What I propose to do... What I propose to do, and this sounds impossible, maybe Nipsey knows also about the laws in the United States, but I'm going to take the match, and I shall light the corner of the envelope. That envelope is going up in flames. By the way, his bill is remaining in view, and at the same time, his bill is being consumed. Let me hold it so that you're not hurt in any way. It happens, by the way, to be a federal offense in the United States to burn or destroy American currency.
Yeah, it costs a dollar.
The other thing, of course, is I'd like the camera to remain on this envelope at all times. The other thing, of course, must be borne in mind. that the bill is being consumed, and we've also created a modest smoke screen. But there goes the window part with the bill in it. I have to let go at this moment. And I'm going to wait, Nipsey, until that entire bill, that entire $1 bill, which you sealed and had concentrated upon,
talk about
consumed.
Money to burn.
The amazing thing is, not only the federal offense that we cannot burn American currency, at least in the United States, but at this moment, aside for the end, except for the edges of this envelope, which is a check-type envelope, the entire contents, bill and all, have been consumed. Now, there is a theory which is accepted by every scientist in the world, a physical scientist, that matter can neither be created
nor destroyed.
It only changes form.
Right.
You'll not believe this, Nipsey. Would you look in the frame? Hold it towards you. Turn the... Open... No, look in the frame itself, into the glass itself. Nipsey, what do you see? Turn this to our camera.
What I see, the human eye will not believe because...
It is a bill. Take this in your hand. Nipsey, read, if you will, the serial numbers on the bill out loud. Our camera cannot get it close enough. Would you read the serial numbers out loud, Nipsey?
The serial numbers on the bill are B as in boy, 3114164.
The same bill. It is yours, Nipsey. Take it out. It is your bill. The very same bill.
I want to show you a little trick of my own. You wouldn't believe I could do this. Move the tray. Move the tray. No, leave this here.
All right.
See, now I'll take this dollar bill, and I'll put it under the picture. I say a few magic words, and the dollar bill will go from under the picture under the pad. Abracadabra. It is now under the pad. Now, wait. That's simple. Anybody could do that. The trick is to move it back from over here to under here.
And it is.
Crazy.
There it is. You know, ladies and gentlemen, what is so intriguing about the life of Freud is that before he died of a terminal illness, he said, had he his life to live over again, he would not have devoted it to psychoanalysis. He would have spent his life investigating parapsychology or ESP. It seems like the circle has come about as he almost inadvertently predicted. Thanks again, and goodbye, everybody.